Following is a non-profit fan-based project. Metroid is copyright Nintendo, Nintendo EAD. Metroid Prime is also copyright Retro Studios. Please support the official release. Hello everyone, this is the Fifth Eye Gamer. Last time, we annihilated the Bryyo Leviathan, killing Mognar in the process. Now we have the Hyper Ball, we can proper explore Elysia. Wow, looks like we're on a gas giant this time. Hello! Sorry about that. Now then, let's touch down. This is gonna be a long one. Wait. Is that Chozo architecture? Well, we'll find out. Got a lot to scan here. Fuel pod max capacities. Contents are safely contained but ignitable by strong impacts. Nah. Structural integrity and minimum. Severe winds deteriorate all support structures over time. Well, that thing's gone. Heavy SkyTown storage units. Yeah, it's another one of these things. We're gonna be seeing quite a lot of them. Right. Now, that out of the way, let's continue. Mechanoid transportation drone. Transports basic supplies to and from various areas of SkyTown. Class D transportation drones are used for the distribution of supplies and materials across all of SkyTown. Upon activation, each unit is assigned a set position along a transit route that it will use exclusively. The constant upkeep of the facility requires that they continuously deliver their shipments to their destinations at a steady pace. Huh.
Samus, your highest priority is to get SkyTown's Aurora unit back online. It will help you find a way to reach the seed. We will upload its coordinates to you now. Proceed with caution. Gore's whereabouts and disposition are still unknown.
Thanks for the heads up, but I can venture a guess as to how he's feeling. Well, looks like we got a ways to go, huh? Chozo bust represents Okwa, a key architect in SkyTown's creation. Huh. Aerial repair drone. Automated maintenance spot. Initial activation 132.8 years ago. I'm gonna just let these things do their work. Mechanoid Databot. Use to store historical data. Shoot to access information. Elysian Data Dock decoded. I am Elysian, descendants of both the Chozo and the First. I am facing the last moments of my life and transferring my memory to the data pod. In a way, our chronicle begins nearly 1500 years ago. That was when our noble creators, the Chozo, began to build that which would become our home. A place of exploration and knowledge flooding the clouds of planet Elysia, a fitting home for its great Chozo builders. They built many linked hovering pods. In time, they formed a net in the skies across the globe, instruments peering out in all directions, studying the cosmos. We did not exist then. Only the Chozo walked these hallowed halls. To the distant stars they looked, and a great many things they discovered, including that which would later spell grim disaster for all. Okay, you see this statue right here? Chozo Elder statue appears stuck. Its arms all stretch as if accepting an offering. Phazon vines are impervious to attack, but growths are vulnerable to Phazon-based weaponry. You can't shoot through the barrier, so you can't actually try to take it down with the Hyper Beam. This is why you need to go to Bryyo first. Okay. Now that's done. We're back at full. Wait, what's that over there? Ornamental frame appears very fragile. Last look at what is that with illegible Chozo markings. Alright. Now that's settled, we should get across. Yeah, this is another one of those fancy doors. They all seem to be different based on the civilization that built them, you see. Unlike the, Federation, the Reptilicus, Chozo, and the Pirates. Oh, and there's also Phazon. Yeah. We've pretty much seen all the variants we can come across, but I'm still going to scan them for 100% completion whenever possible. Wow, this is quite the ride. Might as well get this out of the way now. Structure identified zipline cable. Rails the transit system between pods, connect to it using the grapple beam. Zipline cables are designed as the transit system between pods on SkyTown. Connect and hold the cable using the grapple beam. Yeah. Easy enough. What's that? Lock mechanism engaged. Weapon fire should be adequate to temporarily disengage lock. Well, let's go. Through. Doors, and we're through. Wonder what's going on here. Mechanoid Tinbot, lightweight android that is easily knocked down. Tinbots are made from a lightweight metal, could easily be knocked around from explosions or high-speed impacts. The metal is also quite vulnerable to heat and can be melted by high-temperature weapons. Converted for security duty, the Tinbots now patrol SkyTown tirelessly. They are armed with kinetic beam pistols and can use their two alarms in close combat. Well, looks like they're online now. I better get ready to take them out. Sorry, guys. Okay, what's up with this? Communication satellite has been looping the same signal for the past 208.3 years. Well, that's you. Looks like I can get up there. I better check it out. Ah, crap! That didn't go as well as I'd hoped. That's more like it. So now we're up here. What is this? Cannon is without power. Kinetic charge should be sufficient to energize systems. Kinetic charge? Okay. Guess I'll have to do something about that later. Moving on. Battery unit is connected to holographic projector disc. Unit is online and in need of repairs. Holographic projector is tied into SkyTown's main network. Gore's image is displayed. I think we're looking at a hostile takeover here. Wait, what the? It's an aerial repair drone, but I thought I saw something else. Piston structure provides energy that is used to supply power to the pod engines. Okay, moving on. Open! Oh, this is a thing. Device kinetic orb can, capable of firing small spherical objects at high speeds. The kinetic orb can's original purpose is unclear, but they are capable of firing spherical objects at high speeds to a set target. Airing a can while barf ball will allow you to reach new areas and traverse great distances quickly. It appears in various locations in SkyTown, but most of shutdown require a kinetic charge to activate. Kinetic system online. Yeah, let's go. They even have their own blast shields. Okay, maybe I should see that from a different angle. Chozo bus has deteriorated beyond recognition, unable to reference database files. Okay. And there's a missile expansion. Okay, let's keep going. What the heck is that thing? Locking mechanism activated, simultaneous blast to all targets is required to disengage locks. Yeah, we're gonna need seeker missiles for that one. The heck? The allies within this metal are vulnerable to heat. High temp shots could melt it. Cannon access is blocked. Remove the surrounding debris to enter and use the cannon. Okay, let's go. Whoops! What the heck is that? What the heck is that thing? Apparently, I can't run the scan visor and the grapple beam at the same time. You merry trickster. Door. Another door. And it's gone. Is that some kind of security drone? I honestly... What's that? Mechanoid Steam Lord. Repairs fallen steam bots capable of cloaking itself. Steam Lords command the worker drones of SkyTown. They also repair them when they malfunction or break down. Lightly armored, they rely on the cloaking field to evade their enemies. They will only uncloak to attack or repair fallen steam bots, but can still be detected with an advanced visor system while hidden. Okay. And there it goes. Contact with activated energy beams will result in an injury. It's not right here. I can definitely hear something, though. Wait. Oh, there we go! No, I heard something here. Well, now we're through there. Let's see what else we got. Magnetic rail. All right, spider ball. Down we go. This path. Gears locked shut, unable to open from this side, find an alternate route. Control terminal operates nearby gears, and on the terminal to rotate the gears. Got it. Well, guess I'm gonna have to get rolling. Literally. I hear something. And that device is faulty. Yeah, I can't get that. Gonna have to let it go. Okay, we're in here. And down we go. What's this place? Containment doors sealed. Faint mechanical sounds can be heard coming from within. Elysian recharge chambers are used to house and energize steam bots low on power. Vertical traversal unit requires kinetic charge to activate. Unit is currently offline. Locked in. And there's a steam lord. Those must be steam bots. Gives commands and disappears. Steambot, lightly armed and armored, rendered inert by high temp hits. Steambot's lightly armored exterior can be damaged by any weapons. High temperature weapons are particularly effective and can render them inert beyond repair. Unlike their lightweight cousins, they are made of durable metals and cannot be thrown around. Steambots serve as combat units for steam lords. They are armed with kinetic beam pistols, missile racks, and either tool arms in close combat. That one's off. That one's offline. You'll be back. And he's offline. Wait, is that an energy tank? Yeah, it's an energy tank. Okay. Blast shield lock engaged. Yeah. What's that? Security bars engaged. Scan indicates high amount of pressure holding them in place. Metallic piping system can provide pressure nearby security bars locked shut. Yeah, we're gonna need more energy tanks. That is pretty much a guarantee. Safety release valve. Destroy all valves to release nearby security bars. Okay. That's all three. With that out of the way, let's continue. Is that another data bot? Looks that way. Discovery? The Chozo were watchers, studying the depths of space tirelessly to quench their thirst for knowledge. From this facility, they launch observation satellites, firing them into the heavens towards distant worlds. These satellites returned information that allowed them to analyze the various phenomena occurring across the cosmos. Through this process, they were able to satisfy their intellectual appetite one planet at a time. One day, a Chozo searcher happened upon a very rare discovery. A once-thought-lost satellite delivered information on a distant world. It was incredibly far away, even by Chozo reckoning. Study of the stellar object revealed that it was in many ways a planet, and yet also sentient, alive. This chance event was brief, and the information being collected was lost before the true identity of the plant was discovered. Well, it was revealed. Wait. You wouldn't be talking about Phaze, would you? Lift control system online can require manual out of activation. Yeah. Hand scanner. Okay. What's this? There's nothing I can do here. So we're gonna have to take the lift. Very well. And there we are. Down we go. Or up we go, that is. Well, who'd have thought? Careful of the bots. And here we are, another zip line. Let's go! I don't know what those things are, and they can't be scanned. Just gonna have to shoot them down before anything comes. And we're at our destination. What's that? Safety cap is blocking access. All connected targets must be shot simultaneously to destroy cap. Cannon access is blocked. Remove the cap to enter and use the cannon. Good to know. Something's not right here. Energy generators online, supplying additional power to the interior pod chamber. Mechanoid repair drone. Ground-based automated drone once used for maintenance. The original version of the Elysian repair drone. Because of their limited movement system, the units quickly proved to be insufficient in performing the necessary maintenance duties. Using the base design, the aero model was created to address all flaws of the original version. Made obsolete by the aero model, all production and manufacturing was halted over 150 years ago. Only a handful of these units remain active. Okay. Oh, ice missile door. Save station. About time. We'll keep going. And let's rock. There we are. Now let's see, what's below? Oh, more of those panels. Can't go through there. Phazon. Wait, that's the Aurora unit. Security doors engage. Energize lock with connect charge to gain chamber access. Aurora unit 217 offline. Phazon corruption present. Administer vaccine to repair. Well, can't do it with that thing in the way. Open. Let's see. Morphology, Sky Puffer. Vulnerable basic weaponry, consumes and emits deadly gases. The external shell of a Sky Puffer is incredibly fragile, susceptible to small arms fire. Only a few shots from basic weapons can damage it. Sky Puffers are native to planet Elysia. They feed on the various noxious gases in the atmosphere and are especially fond of Phazon gas. I'll take that if you don't mind. Ow! Jumped right into that one. If I can make it. Well, let's get a move on. Here we go! And here we are. Huh? Gore's powered battle armor. Suit is expanded and empty. Engines have recently been used. Yeah. Well, let's get a move on. Where does this path lead? And another one of those heat doors. Okay. Let's see what we got over there. All right. Let's go through here. Still, what's up with this place? Here we go. And we're... Structure appears to be a landing cradle designed for small evacuation pods. Energy generator feeds power into the landing cradle for recharging evacuation pods. Probably to facilitate transit around the city, if you ask me. At least that's how it appears. Open. Open. We're going this way. What the? Landing pad cover is being held in place before security locks. Currently unable to land your ship. Security locks extended. Cannot be unlocked until AU regains control of SkyTown's network. Well, so much for an alternate landing zone. Let's move. Wait, what's that? Alone? In the year 400 of the Elysian Reckoning, the time for our Chozo creators to leave had arrived. To us, they entrusted the station and its purpose. We were to stand vigil and watch over the station until the time when others seeking knowledge and enlightenment arrived. With the departure came one last request from the Chozo Searcher. To continue exploring the skies for the answers to the mysterious planet. We gave her our word and resumed our tireless search. Day after day, we hunted for the answers she desperately sought, but our efforts yielded nothing. We failed. That is tragic. Thought I saw something. Wait, what's this? Okay. That should open that door. And now you can get back through. That's that. And that takes care of that thing. I don't see a way for that thing to connect to any place I know, so I better just carry on. Now, while we're at it, might as well scan that. Ship missile expansion. Okay. Well, we better get across. Here we go! Alright, so... there's our destination. And we're across now. Okay, open up. What's that? And oh, this is something else. You can't get across. Yeah, those things know we're here now. And they're done. That was easy enough, all things considered. But Gore is still here. What's this way? Oh, what's this? Gate is blocking zipline access. Energy lock is low and power requires more to unlock. I'm not going that way now. I don't have the equipment to actually do anything about it. Which just leaves this door. Time now. And we're another one of you guys. I just can't get enough, huh? Dilapidated gate secures the bridge. The pod hinges look like it could easily be ripped from their mounting. Okay. There we go. What are those? Dragoon Battle Drone. Outer armor's tough, but thruster controls could be ripped off. The Dragoon Battle Drone is a resilient foe, but the thruster controls of the unit are vulnerable and can be easily ripped off. Originally designed to keep local aerial bioforms away from delicate instruments, the Dragoon is now used in a combat role. It carries twin rocket pods for offense. Durable armor and a missile jamming system help keep the unit safe. Sorry! I'll take that if you don't mind. I knew I heard something. Anyway, back to business. All right. Okay, what's up with that bridge? Structural integrity critical, support structures compromised, traversal not recommended. I don't really have a choice. Bear hustle! What the? Ow! Oh, that's that. Steambot leaves, and all the Steambots fall into the abyss. Stylish kill. Fascinating. Didn't know that could actually be done like that. I'll just take the energy if you don't mind. Ah, this is a cannon unit. Apparently it shoots me back over there? Well, guess we'll find out. I'm gonna have to traverse this. Careful. And we're through. What's that? Energy switch requires additional power to activate the connecting lift system. Huh. Well, this is gonna be a thing. Gotta go all the way around here to get up there, huh? No time like the present, I suppose. These large metal panels are being held by placed by clamps within the floating structure. Okay. Safety clamps screen the hatch in place. Remove it to open the hatch. Just like that. All right. Something must be above. That's the first one. That's two. Whatever's causing that sound, I won't be able to get to it for quite a while. As far as I know, anyway. Okay. Now back down. Yeah, there's something up there, alright. For now, we should just get swinging. Ow! How did I not see those things? Okay. Now that we're here. Guess that had nothing. Here we are. We should make our way up, apparently. Oh, gotta go this way. And up.
Our scans have detected a cache of Chozo technology. Perhaps something there will help you gain access to Unit 217. Here are the coordinates.
Well, thank you. Think I have a good idea where that is. Yeah, I was pretty much right on top of it. All right. Huh. Well, we better get this going. Now that that's moved into position, we can get across. Sorry. Wait. No, oh, guess there was nothing to do over that way. Just need to move that into position. Oh well. Back to work. Okay. And I guess that would be our way back. Moving on. Elysian data docs slumber. By the year 600, we of Elysia were low on critical supplies and fuel. We created smaller mechanoids to process fuel from the atmosphere of Elysia, but they proved unable to produce a sufficient supply. Unable to secure the necessary resources to sustain ourselves, we entered a state of hibernation to preserve our remaining stores of energy and parts. While we slumbered, The data collected by the station's equipment was fed to us in dreams. During the long period of sleep, we had many dreams. Countless great events came to us, including reunion with our creators, who had come to call a new planet their home. It was not long before disaster struck. A stellar object hit planet Tallon IV, bringing with it a catastrophic corruption that sent the Chozo world into chaos. We watched helplessly as our creators perished, the few survivors fleeing to an unknown location. Powerless, we slept, and in our dreams, we lamented the death of our creators. This was our final vision, after which we were never able to see our creators again. Okay. Guess we're taking the lift now. Okay. Never mind. Thought you were doing things. What's that? Boost ball. Hey, gimme! Wait, what? Well, that's a thing. Defense drone, antenna, appeared to be fragile, controlling inside armored helmet. The defense drone is used to secure key areas within SkyTown. The externally mounted antennas are tied to the unit's optical ray. By destroying them all, the optical ray will overload and be vulnerable for a short period. This control unit is also vulnerable and must be exposed to be targeted. The timer is immune to small arms fire. Now you know how that works. Alright, let's have to keep shooting the... Alright! This thing sure knows how to fly. Ow! Ow. Well, it's one energy tank down. Sensors are back. All right, then, almost done here. All right, that should open that up. Two tanks. out of the way, let's open this up. Well, things really got steamy in here. Really starting to get noisome. All right, that should be all of that. Now, to take care of you! Right. Die! Wait, what? Now it's offline. Yeah, that's pretty much over. Now to collect all of that. Quite the load we got here. Okay, let's take this. Here we go. All right. And we're back in action. All right. What the heck is that? Device spinner. Boost power control system on online rate reduce. Okay. Ah, spinner. Okay, use a morph ball. Yeah, there we go. That pulls the elevator back into operation. With that said, we should be on our way. Okay. Going up. We might be back there later, just for sweeping's sake. Sorry, not in the mood for your games. Honk. All right. Guess there's nothing to scan. I thought those things that tried to rock an enemy would respawn, be in scanning range. Well, that was a nice, quick little exit. Ow! Well, it takes care of them. I guess they might have gone after the repair drones that were in here. Not that it matters much. Let's get this back online. and we're done here. Ready? Launch! First, for completion's sake, I'll just get this one going again. And that's operational now. I'm gonna have to go straight across. And we're topped off now. Here we go. And we're back. What the heck? There's no zip line here, so I'll just ride the cannon. Right. In we go. Well, that takes care of them. What the? I had that! There we go. Open. We're back. Oh, it's locked in place. Well, we better take care of business while we're here. 242, you merry prankster. And there we go. That opens that up. Okay. Communications terminal, yeah.
The Aurora unit is corrupted and requires repair. Opening maintenance level hatch.
Well, guess we need to go down to take care of that. Okay, what is going on here? AU status screen knowledge is being displayed. Unit is currently offline. Mechanical hatch is locked. Does Peter be any way to open the door? What the? Bots? Where are the bots attacking me now? Well, that's enough. Well, I guess they're offline now, so let's see what's going on. Insertion point identified, upload vaccine to the terminal. Well, here we go. And that should take care of that. Vaccine upload, Phazon corruption level at 0. Huh? Oh. And it looks like he's back now. Something's not right here. I thought it's steam. What? Oh, hey, Gore! You
this
don't.
This is insignificant. I'll show you what I mean. Up there!
What the? Yeah, I suspected this would happen, but really? Dick move, Gore.
Network's been severed. You have no chance of destroying the scene unless you restore the Aurora unit.
Well, that's problematic. He is currently online, but not connected to the network. Circuitry sustained damage. Several connections must be repaired by fusing them together. Well, we better get back and report what happened. Still, Gore. Could you let me out of the room now?
What a terrible dream we were having. Thank you for purging our Phazon corruption and allowing us to awaken. There is much to do. We have communed with AU-242 on Olympus, and learned that a Leviathan impacted Elysia and began spreading corruption. We must destroy this Leviathan and stem the tide of corruption as soon as possible. We have a plan, but Gore's attack severed key communication cables, disrupting our access to SkyTown's primary network. This prevents us from controlling SkyTown and executing our plan to destroy the Leviathan. Gore's plasma cannon should be able to fuse together the severed cables. We must ask you to hunt him down. Gore may have changed Samus. Be prepared to deal with that. Good luck.
And the Aurora unit is online now. Yeah, I'm not banking on Gore being friendly after that. Alright, up we go. And we're back. Okay. Anyway, now'd be a good time for a save break. Alright then. Next time, we do something about Gore. Till then, this is the Fifth Eye Gamer signing off. See you next time.